Want to play The Sims 3 but not sure where to start? This video will walk you through the basics of getting the game and making it work well. Hey everyone, Simmatically here. The Sims 3 is a great game, but if you're a new or returning player, you might not know how to get started today. But it's really not hard, there are just a few simple steps to follow, so let's get right to it. Where to get The Sims 3? You can buy used physical copies, or you can buy the game on the EA app or Steam. Or, in my opinion the best way, you can buy it on Instant Gaming. It's my go-to store for buying games and you can get The Sims 3 at amazing prices. You just click on the search button, type in The Sims 3, then you can optionally check the in-stock box, so it only shows you games that they currently have, and here you can see all the available packs and their prices. At the time of this video, the base game costs just over $1, which is just the best price to get and try The Sims 3. After you buy it, you get a code for the game that you just add to your EA app library, and it works, just like it would if you bought it on the EA app, only cheaper, and it's safe. This is basically how I managed to complete my The Sims 3 collection. You can buy games on Instant Gaming through my affiliate link that is in the description of this video. You still get the games cheaper, but it helps support me and my content. You can also enter my giveaway, where you will have a chance to win a game of your choice every month. So maybe you will win a free Sims 3 expansion pack. Both links are in the description. Once you get the game installed on your computer, it's time to get into tweaking it, adding your GPU. The first thing on my list is to add video card to the list of supported cards so that the game knows how to work with it. You can do it manually, but it's quite tedious. Fortunately, there's a simple program that can do it for you automatically. It works best with Nvidia cards, while only some AMD cards are supported, but it's still best to try it and see if it works for you. I will link to the manual method in the description of this video just in case you need it. The program is available for download at Nexus Mods. You will need an account there to download files, but honestly, it's probably still faster than doing it yourself. Once you have the program on your computer, open it. All you have to do now is find The Sims 3 installation directory, the place where the game is installed. It's possible that the program will find it for you, so you might not have to. It will also tell you if it has your graphic cards in the base and if it's supported. If it doesn't find your game automatically, it will be on one of the drives on your computer. It's not the folder in your documents though. If you're using EA app to play the game, by default, it will be Program Files, EA Games, The Sims 3. But it might be something else you chose when installing the game. Once you find it, open it with the program and then click the green Apply button. Fixing 12th generation or higher Intel CPUs. Now, this part is only for certain players. If you have a 12th generation or higher Intel CPU, The Sims 3 will not start without this fix. To check what CPU you have, you can open your system information, find the processor, and check the number after the hyphen. If it's 12 or higher, you should definitely apply this patch. If it's different, don't bother, but you might want to keep this in mind in case you ever upgrade your PC to a newer CPU and the game won't start anymore. Download the fix from Mod The Sims, all links are in the description of this video, unzip the downloaded file, and run the Alder Lake patch executable file. Go back to your installation directory, now go to Game, Bin, and there will be two files you are looking for. If you install your game from EA app, locate and open TS3 executable. If you got your game from a physical disk or Steam, find and open TS3W executable. You should get a pop-up message saying that the game has been successfully patched. This step is done. Getting the mods folder, where you can put your mods and custom content. Go to this website, download the file by clicking the download button, open it, and move the mods folder to your documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims 3. I have a separate video explaining this step, so you should definitely watch it later to learn more. But if you don't want to watch it, go into your packages folder that is inside mods and remove these two files. Essential NRAS mods. These mods help your game to run smoothly. You need to download three files. Master Controller, which basically serves as a base for some other modules of NRAS mods, but it's good to have it now. Also get Overwatch and Error Trap. Open the zip files and put the package files in Documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims 3, Mods, Packages. Smooth Patch. To make The Sims 3 run well, the Smooth Patch is a must. It's a fan-made patch that significantly improves performance. Go to the download page and select the appropriate version of the patch. Open the downloaded zip file and move all the files to your installation directory, The Sims 3 Game Bin. Move the packages folder to your Documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims 3 Mods folder. In order for Smooth Patch to work, you will need to launch the game using TS3 Patch Launcher executable, which now can be found in The Sims 3 Game Bin. You don't have to open this folder every time you want to play. Just right-click on the file, create a shortcut, and move it to your desktop. Limiting your FPS. It's very important that you limit your FPS so that the game runs better. The best way to do this is through your GPU control panel. For example, for Nvidia, or AMD. If for some reason these options aren't available to you, there's an alternative way to do this. Go to your The Sims 3 game bin and look for the TS3 patch .txt file. It will only be there if you have the Smooth Patch installed. Open it, and what you need to do is change the FPS limit to 60. Save and close the file, turning off all the things that slow down your game. Now you can finally start your game and get ready to play. But it's better for you to turn off the following options. In the main menu, go to Options, General Settings, and turn off Shop Mode, Memories, and Interactive Loading Screens. You can also turn off Lessons if you don't want to see notifications about how to play the game. You can also go to the Online tab and turn off these two options. In the last tab, you can turn on or turn off story progression. The in-game story progression is broken anyway, but you can still deselect all the supernatural characters, celebrities, and horses. Bonus step to speed up game launch. Do yourself a favor and download the No Intro with Max's Logo mod. Put it in the packages folder. With this mod installed, when you start the game, you go straight to the loading screen, which is much faster. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. This video only covers the basics, and there's so much more out there to make The Sims 3 run better. I will be uploading more videos on this topic in the future. In the meantime, you can check out my other videos. I recently uploaded my guide on how I make my Sims look better. I also have videos on game-changing mods, better graphics, and tips and tricks. Be sure to check them out. And if you like this one, leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss my next videos.